In this tutorial, I want to show you how to get started using Google Voice. And what is Google Voice? As it says here, it's a free phone number for life. And here Google has some examples of how you could use Google Voice. You can use it to connect to both your family and work life and other aspects of your life. And really the main idea behind Google Voice is that in today's world, we don't always want to give out our real actual phone number to everybody. Let's say I'm part of a neighborhood organization or a club or a church or a school. Do I want everyone in those organizations to be able to have my real cell phone number? Probably not. And so what you can do is you can set up a Google Voice phone number. You can give that phone number out to whomever you want. And then as they start calling you, you can set certain rules for how you are notified of their phone call. So maybe if it's a close friend that's in that club with you, your actual cell phone rings. If it's not a close friend, then it doesn't ring. But you still get notified at some point that the call came in. Maybe if a family member calls that same Google Voice number, not only does it ring on your cell phone, but it rings at your desk phone at work. Maybe it rings your home phone. So you can set up some rules that kind of protect you and keep certain people at a distance and helps you keep others really close to you. And yet, in both cases, you're able to receive the information you need from those people. So let's get started using Google Voice. Here I am on voice.google.com, and it wants me to sign into my Google account. So I'll just click here in the upper right on Sign In. I am now signed in. If you don't have a Google account, you could go through the steps of creating one and then sign into it. Now that I'm signed into my Google account, notice that Google Voice wants to be able to notify me on this computer. Let's say I'm just working on the computer and someone calls me. It wants to be able to notify me that that's happening. And so it's up to you to decide if you want to allow or block this. I'm going to allow. As it says here, Google Voice is a free phone number to take control of your communication. And at this point, I need to pick a phone number for myself, and only certain numbers are available. So the next step is to search for available numbers by city or area code. So I'll just type in an area code, and it pops up with some suggested phone numbers. And I can just look through these or even click Show More until I find one that looks good to me, that's easy to remember maybe, or that means something to me in some way. So this is the one that stands out to me. This is what I would like to have be my Google Voice number. So I'll click Select. That number has been claimed by me. Now to complete setup and start using Google Voice, you need to verify your existing phone number. So because of this requirement, Google Voice cannot be your only phone number. At least I don't think that it can be. You have to have another phone number somewhere. So I'll click Verify, and then I need to put in my existing phone number. Notice what it says. Inbound calls to your Google Voice number will be forwarded to this number. Google Voice will send you a text message containing a 6-digit code. You can also verify by phone. So if this number is not a cell phone number, you should also be able to just verify it by having Google call you. You pick up the phone and you verify that it is your phone. Give me a minute to put in my phone number and verify it, and then I'll resume the video. Okay, it's verifying my number. This phone number is now reserved for me. Now notice, this is an important message that it gives me. You can use Google Voice on iOS, so on iPhones, on Android phones, and also on the web. So it's possible to set up an app, a Google Voice app, on your cell phone, and be able to use your Google Voice number right from your cell phone. So that's pretty cool. So here I am in my Google Voice homepage, now that my phone number is set up. And notice it welcomes me and says I have one new voicemail. So let's look at that. I'm going to go here on the left side. There's a panel with some tools, and the third icon down is this symbol, which is for my voicemail recordings. And I can check my voicemail just by clicking there. Notice that it gives me a transcription of the message, which is really nice. I can just read through that. I could even copy paste it into a document or into an email. But I can also just go down here and click Play.
Welcome to Google Voice. Google Voice gives you a single phone number that rings all of your phones, saves your voicemail online, and transcribes your voicemail to text.
So that's what it's like to receive a voicemail and to listen to it or read it. Now notice that you can also download the recording. which is a really nice feature. I can download that and save it as an MP3 file.
Welcome to Google Voice. Google Voice can just...
So you can save voicemail that has been left for you. That's a really nice feature. Going back to the first icon, this is the calls icon. It looks like an old-fashioned phone. You can see I have an option to make a call directly from my computer. Type a name or phone number, and then I can click the call button. And then at this point, I need to pick the phone to call with. So I could call with Google Hangouts or with my phone that I already established. So I'll pick that phone. So I click connect, and it's calling that phone number. Now, I don't really want to make that call, so I canceled it. But hopefully you can see how useful that is, that you can make a call basically from your computer, although it does utilize your cell phone. So we've looked at how to receive phone messages and how to call people. Let's jump down here now and look at how to send a text message. So I can send a text message just by typing in the phone number of the person I want to message and then going down here to type a message. So there's my message. If I want to, I can include an image. How about this cat? Click select, and then I'll click the send message button, and my friend just received a text message and a beautiful picture of a cat. So that's pretty easy to send a text message using a computer and your Google Voice account. And you can see there my friend responded, a little bit confused. So sending text messages and making phone calls from your computer and also receiving messages on your computer and calls, those are really good features of Google Voice. But in many cases, you will just be using Google Voice on your own cell phone or home phone. You'll get incoming calls, you'll answer them, you'll make calls using the app, etc. So please do check out the cell phone apps for iOS and Android. It should be pretty self-explanatory once you've signed into your account. But after watching this video, if you'd like some help with the apps, leave a comment in the message below and I can look into making a video about how to use those apps. But it should be pretty simple. In addition to these three icons that we've looked at, we have three dots down here, and that is just another way to get to the different parts of your account. You can jump to messages, voicemail, you can go to the archive. You can archive calls and messages, but you can always go back to them and look at them. You've got your spam folder. There's a way you can mark all messages as read. This is where you can put some credit into your account if you would like to be able to make international phone calls. And then finally, we have settings. And there's a couple of important things in settings that you need to know. It looks like Google Voice is asking to use my microphone. I'm going to allow that as well so I can make calls from my computer. So you can see here in my Google Voice account, it lists my Google Voice number, which I will be changing or deleting. So it's not worth it to try calling it. But anyway, if I do need to delete, I can just click this button, or I could change the number here or transfer the number. Underneath that, I can link more phone numbers. So I could put in my desk phone at work. I could put in my school's phone number, so they call the front desk at the school. I could put in my home phone. And to do that, you simply click to add the phone number, and then you do have to verify the phone number. Next, we have messages, forward messages to linked numbers. If I add more than one phone number, I can decide where those forwarded messages go. I can also receive messages through email if I want to. So I could turn that on or off. Same with calls. Do I want email alerts? I can screen the calls if I want. That's a really cool feature. If you turn on this incoming call options button, you can easily record a phone call just by tapping 4. You can also switch the linked phone with the asterisk button. We've got Do Not Disturb, we've got voicemail settings, and here's the default Google Voice voicemail recording.
The Google subscriber you have called is not available. Please leave a message after the tone.
If you don't like that, you can record another greeting. Just click this button to start recording. Hey guys, call me back when I'm actually available and we'll talk. So I just clicked stop. I can listen to it played back to me. Hey guys, call me back when I'm actually available and we'll talk. I like that, so I'll click save again, and so that now is my greeting. If I want, I can get transcripts and a bunch of other features here. One of the other features I should highlight is this one, filter spam. You can turn that on and it will try to filter out all spam. So these are really some great features in Google Voice. It looks like I just got a call. Here's the call that just came in for me. Looks like somebody wanting to know if I can go out to lunch with them tomorrow. So let's say that this person is someone that I don't really know, and I'd really rather not be bothered by this person's phone calls and messages. I know that's kind of rude, but this is hypothetical. So here, what I can do is I can click here on More Options, and I can go into People and Options, and I can say that this person, and if I know who this person is, I could click the plus sign and I could put their contact name in there and then click Add so that now this person is recognized. And I can mark this caller as being a spam caller. So from now on, if that person tries calling me, it will automatically be marked as spam. I can also block the caller if I want to. And you can see some details of how that works here on the screen. Now, a couple of final things to know when you're using Google Voice. When you log into your account or when you use the app on your phone, you should know that when you see red, that means it's a missed call or a missed message. So that's alerting me that I need to read this message. Once I've read it, now it's no longer the color red. The other thing you should know is that calls I participate in using Google Voice, those still use up my cell phone minutes. It still counts as a cell phone call. So this is not really a way to get around the minutes limits that you might have. So I really like Google Voice, and I think that a lot of teachers will find this particularly useful.